All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat 503. Thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. Coming to you live from Portland, Oregon. Today is Sunday, the 22nd. I was going to do this video last night, but man, I was exhausted after that UCLA big, huge victory there. And so let's get this thing started, people. Thank you guys very much for watching again. First time, long time. Either way, I really appreciate it. Big weekend started off for the Pac-12. We're going to do Pac-12 last week and then next week. Huge weekend started for the Pac-12 with that USC win. USC had to have it. They're in a situation where it felt like they were a little bit reeling after that BYU loss. They had to have it. They come in. They have their first real big test of the year with Utah. Utah's first real big test of the year with USC, and USC looks good, man. Their third string quarterback, are you kidding me on that? So the fact that they even have a chance to keep being successful is amazing. When you lose your first stringer in the first game, you lose your second stringer basically in the second or third game, and then all of a sudden now you've got that back down to your third stringer, and he looks great, like setting records. USC always top flight with talent, always one of the best talented teams in the whole conference. And if they can get it rolling, they're going to be a danger. I still feel like they're probably the number one team in the South. Lots of things have happened, obviously, with them beating Utah. That gives them a leg up on that going forward. But they're still going to get tested this year, and we'll still have to see how they do. Utah, I do think, though, their defense and their special teams is always where they've hung their hat. They need to be able to score the board, score the ball better. They have some pretty good players on that offense, but when they go up against a tough defense, they get a little stagnant. The big day today in the Pac-12 was for the SEC Pac-12 matchup with Cal and Ole Miss. Don't know exactly where Ole Miss is going to be in the shakeup at the end of the year with SEC, but we do know that Cal right now is putting themselves in the upper echelon of that North Division of the Pac-12. Started the year with a win over Washington. That's huge. They already got that in conference. And then they go down to the South and have to play down there in Oxford. That's a tough place to play. And the Land Sharks are coming out. That Land Shark chain with the gold teeth is pretty crazy. And then this game, how it ended, was just insane. Literally insane. That probably should have been reviewed. Ole Miss probably should have had a chance to tie this game up with a two-point conversion. Looked like the guy made the over the line. I got to watch this whole game. The fact that they had that thing right at the end shows Cal needs to be able to finish better. Cal was up on this most of the time, and Cal looked pretty dominant in this game, especially up front. Cal looked really good. Defensive line, offensive line looked really good, and I really like the quarterback. I think Garbers is really good. He's smooth operator. He kind of just hangs in the pocket. He's real smooth. His feet don't move that much. He moves the ball around, and I think Cal's a real danger this year. Cal's going to have, or Oregon's going to have Cal in 2 weeks. Cal hosts ASU this week, so we'll see how it goes. Washington crushes BYU. I thought BYU would have had a better chance in this game, seeing how they played early in the season against some of that other stronger competition, but man, Washington looks real good. If Jacob Eason's not the number one quarterback in the league, it's Herbert or it's 1 and 1A. I tend to think both those guys are literally almost dang near the same type of guy. Both big, both tall, both strong, and both have an absolute cannon across the middle. So Washington proves out on that one, looks really good doing it, and they're, again, to this day, even though they might not have the ranking because of that Cal loss, Oregon, Washington, Cal, all looking to be the upper echelon of the North Division. Oregon with a huge win over Stanford. We talked about this in the other video if you guys want to check that out. Stanford does not look good on offense. Still pretty stout on defense, still able to stop the run, still have good tight end, still have, I mean, the standard stuff that Stanford's used to, but just offensively they cannot move the ball. And it's a real shame because Stanford historically has been just a great team in the Pac-12. Feels like they're taking a step back right now. Oregon's looking good, though. Oregon's defense looking real good. No touchdowns in 3 games. That's pretty sweet. Colorado with a huge upset over ASU, but if you look at how Colorado's played this year, I don't think this is that big of an upset. They played very well against Nebraska. They beat Colorado State. Obviously, they took a loss against Air Force. You're going to have a little bit of a trap game that's going to happen sometimes on the schedule. Couldn't finish that one out. Goes to overtime, and they were close. This one went right down to the wire, and ASU usually wins these games. These close games, ASU's very good at, but in this case, it's just a situation where the Buffs won this one. The Buffs had a great one on this this one. The game of the night is UCLA, man. UCLA goes up to Wazoo and wins 67-63. Are you joking? This game had everything in it. Probably one of those games that they're going to play on TV for the next 10 to 15 years as just one of these classic games. It had everything. DTR looked like one of the best quarterbacks in the league after looking like one of the worst quarterbacks in the league to start the year. That's a tremendous, tremendous jump. And you got to give Chip Kelly a little credit for that one because he has a very young team and these guys are starting to play. Defense was nowhere to be found. I mean, literally, where was the defense in this game? But it does look good, and it does look good for those guys going forward because, again, when you look at a team like UCLA, that's a team that needs to build, and they're going to get better. Okay, next week, let's talk about it. ASU going up to Cal on a Friday night. This is going to be a huge game. I think both these teams are somewhat equal. I think Cal is probably the third best team in the North. I think ASU is about the third best team in the South. So this is a great matchup. See who wins this one. I tend to think Cal can keep it rolling. If Cal goes into this Oregon game undefeated, it's going to get pretty wild. I do think ASU, though, is primed for a win. So I would not be surprised if this is a low-scoring game, somewhere in the teens or the 20s, and it's decided by a field goal. SC plays Washington. This is a huge game. This is probably the game of the week. When you look at USC, USC is just battered, beaten, but they still have the depth. They still have the talent. Washington looks awesome. I tend to think Washington is going to beat SC maybe by a touchdown or two. If Washington is playing like the way they're playing with their speed guys, with their quarterback and their defensive line, they should be just fine. Stanford at Oregon State, this is a tough one. Oregon State is coming off the bye week, coming off their one win of the year. Maybe they're going to get two or three if they can really pull something together at the end of the year, but Stanford's looking to finally get a win here. They've gone three weeks in a row with a loss. They're going to need to try to right the ship, and I would hate to be the Beavs right now against Stanford. Only problem is I don't know if Stanford's going to be able to score that much. Oregon State's defense not great, but Oregon State's offense is good enough to keep them in this game. And I think Oregon State might be able to score more points than Stanford. That's just how this goes, especially on the outside. Stanford looked susceptible against the pass. The run, they're going to stop it. So whether Jamar Jefferson comes back healthy or not, I think he should be. But you're talking about Oregon State and Stanford as being a slugfest. I do think Stanford's going to win this game, but I think Oregon State keeps it close. Wazoo at Utah, huge game for both these teams, both coming off losses, not happy about where they're sitting right now. I can tell you that Washington State's going to score points. I can tell you that Utah's going to play good defense. So this should be a good matchup. Whether or not Utah can score points and Washington State can stop them, that's the next question. Washington State's defense did not look good against UCLA, so I think Utah might have a chance to get in there and score some points against this Coug team. Cougs literally Cooged it. The epitome of Cooging it is this game, and they're 32 points, and they let UCLA come back. So there's going to be a little bit of a hangover, or it's going to be like flush it and move on to the next one because we are pissed. UCLA at Arizona. This is a huge game because UCLA comes off this huge win. 2 weeks ago, this is a game that people are not really concerned about. Arizona's got great offense, and they can keep the ball rolling. Watch the hell out because they can score some points. It looks like UCLA's in that exact same boat, so this game should be a super fun game to watch. Pac-12 after dark, going to light up the scoreboard, and not much defense to be shown. All right, guys, thank you guys for watching Sports Chat 503. Check me out next week. Adios.